and then we're across from Shell's, and then you stop because you can't see, and I was like, I had the courage. I was like, bitch, let's switch. And I was, she was like, okay.
I drive stick in a lower car.
I don't know how to drive stick. Hi Barbies! Welcome back to our channel. If you don't know who we are, my name is Nuki.
And I'm Diana.
Today we're gonna be doing an Oyster Mukbang!
And also gonna be telling three different stories. It's gonna be her story of the first time she got drunk.
Yeah.
My story of the first time we got drunk. And then
there's a crazy story of when we got drunk together.
So let's just start eating.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you what I like on my oysters first, really quickly. My favorite go-to is Tabasco and lime.
And we didn't make the lemon sauce.
I don't even care.
Well, I'll just eat it like this. I'm gonna eat it the same way she is, but we're gonna go first and we're gonna do an oyster shooter.
Yeah.
They're like a little cooked because we like put them in there for like a minute. Like, and then we were like, oh yeah, we're gonna do that. So yeah.
Yeah. This is kind of scary. This is my first ever oyster shooter. I don't like eating raw things, but. The whole thing in my mouth. I bet can't.
Slimy.
Is it? That is slimy.
I know you don't want to eat it. Spit it out if you don't care.
I can do it. Okay. Well, story time. Before story time, we need to crack our beers. The first time I've ever gotten drunk, honestly, it's a pretty boring story, but I just got back from high school and then I got home and I was like, oh cool, look at this, you know, Absolut green apple vodka. I was like, that sounds good, just let me try it. How bad can it be? And I took a shot of it, a pretty big gulp, and I just died. I snorted everything out, threw up. Like, I was like, ugh.
Everclear is, like, hell.
I've taken Everclear once.
Like, an actual shot of it?
Mm-hmm. And it fucked me up. I was super emotional, too, at the time. So I was, like, crying all over the place. And then I knocked out and puked in the bathroom. And it was at my cousin's house, too. And it's, like, my cousin's kickback that I wasn't invited to. That was the first time I ever drank with Ying.
Really?
Yeah.
How old were you?
Like, 16. I'm so serious.
The first time I ever got drunk, I'm sorry, Mom. I know you already know this. But I stole a bottle from her. And it was when I was moving out of her house. We were fighting and I was like, this is my last time I'm ever gonna be here. I'm gonna steal a bottle. And it was a bottle of it was like a $10 bottle of like spice rum. It was nothing good.
Spice rum?
Yeah. So that's the first type of alcohol I ever drank. Like, it was like, and we took, I was so sad too, because I was in an emotional time in my life too. And I was not going through a breakup, but I was just fighting with my boyfriend at the time. And so basically, I got one of my friends that were no longer friends now, but basically we decided to get drunk and do it in my room. We drank the whole bottle at 6 p.m. and got drunk by 6:30 and then started throwing up everywhere in my room. She threw up all over my laptop, all over my pillow, and flipped it over, and we just kept cleaning. And then by the time it came to like 8 o'clock, my dad came in the room and was like, what are you guys doing? And I'm like, we're just high. And he's like, no, you're not. And I'm like, I'm just high. He's like,
yeah, I'm just high.
Yeah, I was like falling around. It was so crazy. It kind of sucked because at that time, we were like so young where you don't know how fast it hits our body, because we did the OLCC.
Yeah, and that shit hits your bloodstream in 5 minutes.
Like, really, really fast. And the sad part about it is, I think I was only like 14. So the next day, I had like the worst hangover ever.
While I was talking to the camera, and I was like, it's like, oh my God.
There's like everywhere. We're also filming in like my backyard. We thought that it'd be more like, you know, because we had to barbecue these.
Yeah.
So.
And honestly, I love this color background.
Yeah, it's so pretty.
Matches our beers.
Getting drunk isn't something I can really do though. Like, I can. Not saying that I don't know my limit. It seems like every time I go and drink, when I lay down, my head is spinning no matter what. No matter what, and that's the part I hate. I can't stand it because I sit there, and what? Like 3 days ago, when we drank with Jackson, I went home and I died.
Bro,
I died.
I don't know. Okay, you went home, you died. Johnny, remember how Johnny came and he stayed for like 30 minutes to an hour waiting for me, but then I never went home with him? I went home. I was falling over. I somehow got myself in the shower.
Hold on. How did I drive? I drove you home.
You did drive me home. Oh my God. I totally forgot about that.
We did not condone drinking and driving.
Yeah. I got home, I got myself in the shower, I washed myself, I was like, be quiet, stomping all over all the shoes. And then,
be quiet.
I got out of bed, I started eating some hot Cheetos and cereal. And then my parents busted in the room, I was like, hi. And my mom's like, I got a splinter, do this for me. I was like, okay. Like, I tried pretending acting non-drunk, and I was like,
you think she could smell it though?
Probably.
We're drinking Henny.
But she walked out right out. I was like, oh my God, where's the splinter? And I grabbed it out. Oh my God, it was so bad.
When that night, we killed that Henny so fast. I don't even know how.
Like, okay, we were there for 3 hours. We left your house around like 7:40 to go get the bottle before they closed.
And then I did laundry and then went to Rhonda's.
Mm-hmm. And then like you got to Harrison around like 8:20-ish. And like the bottle was like, okay, pretend this is the bottle. The bottle is like down to right here. And then we drank more and then it was down to like right here. And then like we drank a little bit more and then Rafa and Ron killed it.
I just remember Ron coughing really hard because it came out too fast of the bottle. He didn't expect it to come out like that.
It was like this.
Yeah, and then he coughed and his glasses flew off his face. And I was like, what?
Oh yeah, you're like, oh my God, your glasses.
I was like, because I was so confused how any of that happened.
That was a wild night. We just stayed there for so long. I can't believe we stayed there for 3 hours.
But
do you put the shells back?
You don't have to.
I've been throwing them away. I just fuck it. Just keep it like that.
Just throw it away.
Fuck it.
The place that we've stayed the longest time is fucking Lux.
Yes.
We've stayed there from like 9 to almost 5 in the morning.
Uh-huh.
And that's just a hookah bar here in Portland, Oregon.
It's
like,
so
but our third story was really about that though.
It really is. It was the craziest.
But basically, time ever. People get into fights. So let's explain what Lux kind of is and what happens.
Like, we're kids 18 and up, go to a hookah bar. And literally, it's like a nightclub, and they just dance the night away, get drunk at their cars, go inside, dance, and hookah. And literally, there are fights every single night that it's popping. Like every single night.
And it's always like guys really trying to act bold. Like, I don't even care. Bitches be fighting for guys that aren't even theirs. Like, I'm just like, like, females will come out the cuts and start swinging. Like, I stand back and just grab Nuki and we just sit there together.
We just grab each other and, like, and film. Yes. I have so many videos, though I'm not gonna show because that's confidential.
People are gonna get mad.
A bitch already got mad at me.
But it didn't really matter because she fought for someone who wasn't even her man, so.
Right. She tried coming at me even though I wasn't
even talking to him or anything.
Exactly. I don't know. Bitches are weird.
What was the beginning of the night? What all happened? Because I know I got pepper sprayed that night. But what all led up for me to get pepper sprayed?
That night was so blurry.
Why did...
But, okay. Was it a music video night? No.
Because all I know is that I got pepper sprayed and you drove, but what happened?
Oh, it was that night that you... Was it? Which that night that you and Lupe fought? No, it wasn't. I don't know.
I think Frankie got pepper sprayed, and then I was like, whoa, that's wrong, or something like that. And then he pepper sprayed me, and then we both were like, whoa, what the fuck's happening?
There and then I don't fight. Know, I did not know where the fuck you were. And then when you came over, you're like, my eyes. I'm like, what? I'm like, I have pepper spray in my eyes. I was like, bitch, what? How? And then you're like, let's go, the cops are here. And I'm like, let's go.
It was so bad, like. I know that, like, pepper spray is, like, intended to hurt you, but it was, like...
I could not imagine the
pain. I lost my contacts. I had one...
sponsored contacts, and we were wearing it that night.
I had one contact in my eye, and I was, like, it literally was, like... Because I had my wig on that night, too, I swear.
We both had
our wigs on, because I remember I was, like, freaking out, crying.
It was that night that you had your short, blonde wig.
Yeah. Well, I got pepper sprayed in my wig. How ghetto.
Well, anyways, we all hopped in the car, and then this big black guy, he also hopped in the back seat. And then both of them were pepper sprayed. We drove out somehow.
And he was like, he would kept saying, like, I want to get out of the car. I'm trying to get out. And we're like, why? I thought you needed to get away.
Exactly. He's like, I can't be here when the cops are here.
Oh, so. No. Before that, though, I pulled out of the parking lot and then we switched drivers.
No.
Because you dropped him off.
No.
Are you
like,
sure?
We pulled out of Lex. You pulled out of Lex.
This one was not good all the way.
You pulled out of Lex. We passed the light and then we were across from Shell's. And then you stop because you can't see. And I was like, I had the courage. I was like, bitch, let's switch. And I was, she was like, okay.
I drive stick in a lower car.
I don't know
car.
How to drive stick. We switch. I kick the nigga out. He's like, wait. I was like, bye, I gotta go.
And he, to this day, I'm just gonna say it. He took our friend's shoe.
He took our friend's high heel and
never returned it.
Ever.
And then later on, when we... Okay. Just really quick. Later on, when we found him, he was washing his shirt. He was washing his face in a puddle because it hurt so badly. And he ran blocks, let me tell you. At least 15 blocks trying to get away from it all.
That shit was so crazy.
It was so bad. Not only that, is we drove...
We drove to your house and we're like, why are we going to your house? We can't go into your house like this. So we drive all the way back to Lux and me not knowing how to fucking drive. I don't even know how I even switched it.
Oh, I remember because I was like this in the seat and I was like, put the clutch in, take the clutch out. I'm like, yeah. Put it in first.
I was like, clutch, what? Is this first gear? Let's keep going, fuck it.
It was the craziest.
Your car is so fucking loud too. Everybody can hear. It's like, durr, durr, durr. It's like, oh my god.
You're like, I can't do this.
We got to Lux. The cops are still there.
Why did we even go back?
I don't know.
Oh, we went there to go get Lupe.
He was like, where are y'all?
Oh, he was like, where the fuck?
Let's go.
I'm about to go down.
Where?
Kim's house.
Uh-huh.
We're just out here chilling. But she got there, still don't know how to shift. We were so fucking loud in front of the cops. Like, it was like, dur, 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 dur. I was like, fuck, I can't get this right.
I remember that.
We repassed the cop and you were still driving really bad.
And then we just went
and up. You're like, why didn't we get stopped? I was like, I don't know.
Oh, we were so drunk.
How did the cops pepper spray me and then let me leave?
Right.
I
just don't get it.
How ethnical is that? Don't you keep track of the people you pepper sprayed? Don't you have to write down who you pepper sprayed for the night or anything? Mm-hmm. I feel like you've got to do that, and I just know that.
Memorize. Unless you'd be pepper spraying it, like hella people every other day.
They're like, fuck it. Mm-hmm. Like, this bottle's still full.
So, unfortunately, this is the end of this video. We will be doing another mukbang just because this was incompleted and it is to make it up to you guys. It will be a Halloween themed. We will be eating some creepy critters. So stay tuned for that. I'm so sorry that we really didn't finish this video, but it was a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoyed it and give us a thumbs up if you did. And also subscribe to her channel, and we'll see you in our next video. Bye.